In part 2 of our lesson on trig equations with multiple angles, you will learn how to find all possible solutions after applying a trig identity. In this example, we have to find all possible degree solutions to the equation cosine 7x equals secant 7x. Now, we know we need the same trig function on each side, and we have a reciprocal identity that we can use on the right-hand side to make it become 1 over the cosine of 7x. The left-hand side stays cosine 7x. We can cross-multiply the cosine of 7x up to the left-hand side. So now we have cosine squared of 7x has to equal 1. We can apply the square roots property to say then that cosine of 7x is going to have to equal plus or minus 1. So let's draw a picture here. We know that for cosine to equal 1 means that we have to be at an angle of 0 degrees. We know that the cosine of 0 degrees is equal to 1. But in our equation, we could have plus or minus 1. We know that the cosine is negative 1 over here at 180 degrees. Looking at these two solutions, we can see that they are actually 180 degrees apart from each other. So when we make our equations here, we can take the argument of our function, which is 7x. We can set it to the first angle where it happens, which is 0 degrees, and then we add in 180 degrees times n because we're going halfway around. So starting at 0, if we add 180, we end up at 180. If we add another 180, we would get 360. If we add another 180, we get 540, and it will bounce us back and forth between all the angles coterminal with 0 and all the angles coterminal with 180. Now, you could also solve two equations where you take 7x and set it equal to 0 plus 360 degrees n, or you take 7x and set it equal to 180 degrees plus 360 degrees n, or instead you can combine them into one equation as we've done, where you take 7x is equal to 0 plus 180 degrees n. So we have 7x is 180 degrees times n. We would need to divide both sides by 7. We get x is equal to 180 degrees times n over 7. And this formula will find all the infinitely many solutions to our equation. In this example, we have to find all possible degree solutions to the equation sine 2 theta is equal to 2 cosine squared theta. So we notice that we have two different arguments here. This one has an argument of 2 theta. This one has an argument of theta. And we know that we can use a trig identity to help with that. So sine of 2 theta can be replaced with 2 sine theta cosine theta. The right-hand side stays the same, 2 cosine squared theta. Now we can divide both sides by 2, so the 2's are gone, and we have sine theta cosine theta is equal to cosine squared theta. We know that now we need to get all of our trig functions on one side. So if we bring everything to the left-hand side, we have sine theta cosine theta minus cosine squared of theta is equal to 0. We see that we can factor out a cosine theta, and we will have left sine theta minus cosine theta equals 0. Using the zero product property, we know that we will set cosine theta equal to 0, or sine theta minus cosine theta equals 0. In this first equation, we have cosine theta is equal to 0, and we know that cosine is equal to 0 here at 90 degrees, or here at 270 degrees. Now, once again, these two sets of angles are only 180 degrees apart from each other, so we can write this as one formula where we say theta will be 90 degrees plus 180 degrees times n. And remember what this means. You start at 90, which we would start here, and then this tells you that from that 90-degree start point, you're just going to go halfway around and stop, and you would be at another solution. Go halfway around and stop, you would be at another solution. Halfway around and stop, you get the next one. Halfway around and stop, you get the next one, and so on. So that's our first formula. We still have to solve the second equation. Now, in this case, you have sine theta minus cosine theta is 0. Here's my suggestion. Turn this into sine of theta equals cosine of theta. And we can divide by cosine theta. So we would have sine theta divided by cosine of theta is equal to 1, and we know that sine theta over cosine theta is tangent theta has to equal 1. When the tangent is positive, we know that means we are going to be in quadrant 1 or 3. Using our special angle chart, we go to the tangent row where the value is 1, and we see that our reference angle is going to be 45 degrees. So putting the reference angle in quadrant 1, of course, then we get 45 degrees. Putting the reference angle in quadrant 3, we are going to get 225 degrees. And once again, we notice that these angles are opposite rays of each other, which means they're going to be 180 degrees apart from each other. and we are going to be able to combine our formula into one and get that theta will be starting at 45 degrees and then going halfway around, so plus 180 degrees times n. So these two formulas together give us all the possible degree solutions to our equation.